This your brother?
Yo, what?
Who's this?
That's my friend Betty.
Fuck, man. Let me get this shit.
Turn your camera sideways, Betty. There you go. You gotta turn your audio on.
Yeah, the audio.
I can't hear you.
There we go. Okay.
Yeah. Hello, Betty.
Betty Solomon. Are you Jewish?
Yeah. No. Jesus, who is this?
Oh, shit. Nothing wrong with that. I was about to say Shalom. Where you get the name Solomon from?
Huh? My dad.
Wow.
Business already, Shalom.
I tell you mm-hmm. one thing. You will always get picked up from with that name, Solomon.
Yeah. And,
do you see that? Hello? You ain't got to never worry about nobody. That's why it was a famous producer. You ever heard, he used to do records, something Bird. He's a black dude.
Young Bird.
You know the shoe? What's his name?
Young Bird?
Said Young Bird? No, I don't think
no,
so.
No. He's older now.
It's current.
He was a Massenburg. Kedar Massenburg. You ever heard of him? You never heard of Kedar Massenburg?
Who the fuck is that, Shambo?
He's a black dude. He was huge in the industry, in the music, and the black dude.
What decade?
Yeah. That's a great question.
That's a whole nother story. But he was real. He was real short, and he was very powerful with all types of music. And his reason why I say that, because his last name was Massenburg. And I said, God damn. And I think he said he made his name that so he could get, you know, so people pick up the phone. Anyway,
I brought Betty here to
Hey, Betty.
Express. Hi.
Betty is an active, this is the person I discussed the Joe Budden podcast with.
Oh, yeah.
Oh!
Yeah. It's
so
it's you. It's only Kate. Yeah.
To kind of it's break it down else. For you,
Shampoo. Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Not like a thank you.
I need that. Lord. I need that. Don't look for Lord. He right.
Because he has a theory. Shampoo wanted them to stay at Spotify. He all this shit.
Always stay next to the white man. Always. It's the only way we're going to succeed.
Anyway, Betty, how did you feel about the return of Rory and Maul on the podcast?
It's not the same. The chemistry it's been off for a while. And I mean, you could just tell that they are trying. You can tell that they've had some conversations. And I think that's it just kind of revealed how much of a friendship they might not have had compared to like his other friends. I think it just kind of showed, not like there's nothing bad about that. I think the strength of a friendship definitely comes through when you can come back from like whatever tussle argument, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. But also business is involved. So I have a feeling that one out of the two parties that came back is probably waiting for this contract to be up. That's my opinion. Cause Joe has dropped enough times that they're written into some type of contract, you know, like an agreement of how long they're going to be on the show.
He just said that on Shaking the Tree episode.
Yeah. Yeah. He's mentioned it a few times, especially while they were out. So I think they just came back just to kind of honor that, to not get in any kind of trouble with him also legally, because nobody wants to get caught up in that, depending on how much money they got.
My question is this, and this is no disrespect to what's their names, Rory and Maul. This is no disrespect to them, but what would they do without Joe Budden? Who cares about them without Joe Budden? I hate to be harsh, but this is just how I feel.
Yeah.
I called them. We made a cold call to them. You know what
Did
a cold
you
call?
Them all, like I told you.
Oh, I'm familiar.
Yeah, cold call. I just people in yet don't know about the industry. Cold call is when you just call somebody cold.
Yeah.
I'm teaching the industry. I'm teaching the audience. Get out of that TV line.
Did you text Maul? What did Maul say to you, Shampoo?
I didn't text him. I forgot to text him. But we called him on the air and he picked up. And I was joking around with him, but I was saying that you're probably upset because Joe didn't involve you in the contract talks. with Spotify, because I'm thinking as a black man, right? This mm-hmm. is just me.
Mm-hmm.
If you're trying to break away in this industry, I don't care what it's rap, I don't care if it's television, I don't care if it's whatever, books, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
The key to it is to get to the white man. That no, I'm serious. That's the only way we're going to get what
God,
and it's not.
You lost. You were going good until you said that dumb shit.
I show you proof.
There's no proof. You've gotten to the white man plenty of times.
No.
You're on the white man's show every week. Every week you're on the white man's show.
All right. Now you done?
You want to keep going?
The right white man.
That's
the white man that's going to say, yo, you know what? I'm gonna invest in this dude, which is not a bad thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
You can ask Steve Harvey. You can ask. They won't say it to you because it don't sound right. But if you catch them niggas in a bar and they drinking, I'll be like, shit, when did you get your break? And I bet you he said, when I walked into so-and-so.
Did Betty just leave?
No, sorry. I had a call. They popped in. Sorry.
I digress from that. But what I'm saying is when you have a good thing going, right, you shouldn't try to upset it if it's working. Does that make any sense?
It does make sense, but the episode they came back on was Shaking the Tree. Shaking the Tree was the first one, then You Have the Floor was this past one.
Yes.
So from my understanding, Maul is I don't personally know them. You know, I'm going off of being a fan of this show for I don't know how many years. Oh yeah. I mean, I've been, I know KJ from like the radio background. So I've been in regular radio and I've also like been involved in podcasts. And I understand to some extent of how it goes.
Me.
Yeah.
That's me.
Oh, sorry, Space. Sorry. I keep forgetting you're a different person. Oh, I keep forgetting I'm doing a bad job.
This guy got so many aliases.
I know. He wants to stay mysterious.
AJ. Yeah. Alias, he don't want to get caught. You know, he got another name called Little J.
But yeah, so basically, I think the whole deal is, I'm trying to stay on track.
Bye, baby.
But basically from listening to the show, like since before he had a name for the show, when it was, I'm going to name this podcast later, like when it was that, being a fan since then, Maul has always taken me as someone as like, there's certain things I stand with, certain things I don't. And if I don't like it, I don't like it. I don't care what is around it. And that's what cool. It sounded like it was. Yeah. So I understand his issue. And from that episode, I know they sounded like they were joking and laughing at the end, but I was like,
no,
this is enough of a window into what's going on in real life that I think they just have two different points of view. And Joe just was very like, you know, corporate in his response, I don't think there's any way for them to really reconcile what's really happening. And I think they're just trying to finish whatever agreement
band. And let me tell you something. When they brought the other two people on,
mm-hmm.
that was a big gamble for him, for Joe Budden. Yeah. Like, I know he was nervous, right? He was so nervous he should have said it. That would have made him calm. That's the way I do things. I'm like, God damn, I'm nervous. I hope y'all motherfuckers as good as them shit. You know what I'm saying? But that's the way I move. But their show was good. I didn't miss those two. You understand what I'm saying? So when the guy sitting in the big chair, Maul, when he said you should have cut off the show when we left, that was they got to understand that Joe Budden been doing this for years. He used to substitute on Hot 97 when they was out.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? He like this morning he did rap. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. He liked to talk to people. Like, you could tell, right? I'm going to tell you right now, I don't get it. So I don't know how you got two episodes. But I watched it, right? But what I'm saying is, mm-hmm. they think that they wanted to prove to him that they could take the show down by leaving. That's what they was doing. Because
I don't think so.
I think so.
To me, it's from the beginning of how Rory explained it and how Maul reacted to the situation. I feel like, first of all, let's be real. If this was any other venue of entertainment, right? So if this was a TV show and two of your co-hosts, your main co-hosts leave, they're putting everything on pause, coming up with whatever excuse until they figure it out. I understand their positioning because they're saying, why would you continue and not really make a bigger effort to reconcile our issues, whether it would have came out with a good result or a bad result? Why wouldn't you just take the time to fix it instead of having these episodes with two other people? And then on top of everything, and I don't know if they listened to the episodes, he was dropping slights on every episode with Ice and Ish. And in my mind, I'm like, But those are the things about Joe that I'm like, again, I don't personally know anybody, but this is just from my perspective. It's like, I would feel the same way. Like, you don't want to fix this with me, but you want to keep dropping slights.
Yeah, but
you're being corporate.
Yeah, but you missed the part where Joe said you were supposed to meet me somewhere, Maul. That right? You were supposed to meet me somewhere and you stood me up.
Yeah.
Remember that?
Yeah.
Yeah. But you didn't say that when you left that out.
But he's
the one who fucked up to begin with.
Who fucked up?
Joe Biden fucked up to begin with.
He came out the gate and told somebody to stay home, the shit fell apart.
He's the reason. There's no other reason.
Why? Why do you think that? Why do you think they had an argument? Because Betty seems pretty perceptive. What was they arguing about? I don't get it.
The argument started with him telling Rory not to come in for a couple episodes. Like, just take some time off. Like, that to me.
Yeah, but what do you think they're arguing about? That's my question.
It's a deeper issue than that, Betty.
Yeah, like, that's what I'm saying. That's the stuff that we don't need to know. That's whatever they've got going on, Avi. But, I mean, to be honest, I'm sure you guys listen. They've been like this for a couple months where it sounds like Rory and Joe are about to have a fist fight.
I wouldn't know.
Every episode, as a fan, like this, it already sounded like this is funny, but not funny because it sounds like y'all really want to fight each other.
Wait, let me ask you something. because I hope you give me the right answer. Do you think that was a right move to leave Spotify?
Yeah.
What?
Because I, from a business perspective, again, I don't know all the dealings, but from what it sounded like, they weren't getting their worth, and it sounded like they were trying to downplay them, and they were trying to
negotiate.
Basically,
let me tell you something.
You're talking to a down negotiator.
No.
I tried to negotiate for this show, and he brought the value back down. Like, he put it back down. Yo, we could get this. He's like, nah, man, they take it too long. Let's just do it. Like, he just
because
listen, who he who speaks first, Shampoo. You gotta chill, man.
But listen, I hear what you're saying at Spotify. But see, that's the problem. That's the problem with people getting into entertainment or making a record or some fluke where they make millions of dollars, right? And they forget about the guy that's working on the roof or the guy picking up the garbage like I did for 30 years or people at work. When I hear people's psyche about, they weren't giving me my worth at this place, so I left. That no place is going to give you your worth unless you're worth it. Maybe to them, you wasn't worth the money. They wouldn't do that. Obviously,
they were wrong.
This is a longer conversation, but in my opinion, and also, again, I haven't worked in radio and having some understanding from some mutual friends that have worked at record labels. They are not valuing the stream to anybody outside of their environment at what it actually is. We are still asking the same question as an artist, as a musician, as a podcaster, and I don't think they were going to give them the real value.
Because we don't get paid.
I think he just
audio streams.
He just took that Spotify deal just to get metrics so he could shop around and get a better deal.
Obviously, the deal
that they have with Cash App, it sounds like they made a good amount of money. He does a good job of telling enough of what's going on for us to put the picture together. So from listening to Joe specifically in the past 3-4 episodes, he's saying they made some good money on this Cash App deal and they're doing all right.
To be honest, they make the most out of most podcasts out here. It's either them or Charlamagne. Like, it's not money, Shampoo.
Well, let me ask you a question. Are they making more money now than they did with Spotify?
I don't think we'll know unless you put that info out there.
Let me ask you a question, Betty, because this guy don't never want to. If it's raining, you want to be out of the house or in the house?
All right. Thank you for your time, man.
Give it to me. Oh, come on.
Because what kind of fucking crypto?
If it's raining, would you rather be in the house or outside? It's a simple question.
I'll end with this, and then I'll let y'all get back to what y'all are doing. I would hate to. I want to be clear because I don't know how this is going to be cut up and put out into the world. Okay. I would love nothing more than to continue to see these four guys continue to prosper. I love this show. I love all four opinions. I listen to the show mainly for the male opinion, and it's great. It's literally like sitting in the midst of like a bunch of my best male friends. That's what listening to that show is like. So I appreciate it and I love it, but I don't think that we have a couple of months maybe at that of or whatever is the contractual obligation. But Maul is more quiet now than he was before. He definitely is very
angry. Oh, he was
a mouse.
Angry.
He's still a
Shampoo,
mouse in the corner, but
Shampoo
more quiet than
it's his fault.
Who Maul's fault?
And Shampoo's like condescending
because
egotistical mind. He thinks because we called him and said that shit we said, that this whole shit happened.
Because, hey, Betty.
I don't think they care. Because when we called him, right, he hung up on us because he was talking crazy.
Yeah. Everybody does. Right.
It's not the call because we said Patreon gave us the phone number. We said all type of shit. So he said, it's not the phone call that we made. It's the one he makes after about us.
Yes. He's going to say someone
that matters.
He probably said, Joe, some crazy motherfucker from the Howard Stern show talking about King All Black said that I'm mad because you didn't include me in the Spotify deal. And then Joe said, well, this ain't your business. Didn't he say this ain't your business? All right, then there we go.
Wow.
There we go.
You're spinning this. You are.
Yeah, he swears. I don't think that's how it went, but he just. He's
that's right. But wishful thinking.
thinking. But I can't let you go. I can't let you go without answering the question. If it's raining, do you want to be in the house or outside?
Am I wearing a raincoat and do I have an umbrella?
You wear a raincoat, umbrella,
then I can hang 10 outside.
No. you can't have rain gear. You can't have rain gear.
I can't have rain gear?
No.
So now the circumstances change?
No, they never, it was always you outside and you know, working, whatever you're doing, you know, coming from work. But it's raining. And
like, what are you talking about?
Oh, here he go. That's you, Betty. You try to throw that in there.
Because what is that?
Answer the question, Betty. Would you rather be outside or inside if it's raining?
Is it warm? Is it cold? Like, what kind of logistics?
Oh, it's cold. It's warm. It's all kind of seasons. All season.
I feel like I'm answering a trick question. That's why I'm asking.
It's not a trick question. I'd rather be inside. That's it.
Okay.
Fine that I'm outside.
That's the right answer. All right. Thank you. All right. Take care. Lisa,
thank you, Betty.
Strong to the bone. Thank you, Betty.
Thanks,
you're
guys.
The most.
Thanks
you're the
you.
Most articulate and professional person to come on.
I have to agree with that. And I'm not used to it.
Anytime.
Your nails look nice.
Thanks.
All right, baby.
See you guys later.
Take care.